everyone, and welcome to my new Dory Paint video. As you could see it already from the thumbnail, today we are going to make a Billie Eilish doll. And of course, Billie Eilish is probably one of the most popular singers at the moment. And even though, you know, I'm not very much myself into those popular things, normally I just refuse to follow all these hyping things. But this time I can agree that Billie Eilish 100% deserves all this hype, all this popularity, because she's just good. The music is good. The voice is good, the way she performs is amazing, she has the charisma, she has the darkness inside of her, and it's also 100% up to date. So I really think she's an amazing artist, and guys, she's also very young, so I think she has the potential to become really a huge star, really a superstar. So while I'm completely under Billie's charms, I think it's time for us to make a Billie doll. And it was quite difficult, of course, to find a doll for this transformation, because all these Monster High dolls and Barbie dolls, there was always something off in them. And the only doll that could give me that Billie Eilish feeling has become this tiny Howlin doll. First of all, she has a little bit different body type. She has this more like teenager's body, and that's why she looks a little bit more like Billie Eilish to me than all these adult, big, with long legs, model-looking Monster High and Barbie dolls. And there's also something in her character that gives me this, you know, indie singer vibe. So let's work on this doll a little bit and let's try to turn her into Billie Eilish. Of course, in this kind of a transformation, we will not be able to reach 100% realness, because this doll is not sculpted like Billie Eilish. I mean, like, the jawline will be different, the skull bones will be different, the distance between the nose and the lips is not exactly the same, but let's anyway try to push max out of this doll. And what is the most important, let's try to catch the spirit, the vibe of Billie Eilish. And I'm going to start, like always, with my basic preparations. You know, of course, all the first steps already very well if you're watching my videos sometimes. First of all, I'm going to remove her outfit, and then I'm going to cut her hair as short as I can. And if you're suddenly for the first time on my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe. We're playing here with dolls every week Friday, so welcome to the family. And I will start the transformation. Then I'm using hot air of my hair dryer to make the head soft and to melt the glue inside of the head. And when the head gets very soft, I can disconnect it from the body, and then using my old tweezers, I pull the rest of the hair out. And then I can remove all the paint from her face using pure acetone. Okay, now it's time for a little plastic surgery. And first of all, I would like to adjust a little bit the tip of her nose to make it look a little bit more like Billie's nose. This part is a little bit smaller and not so round like the doll's nose. So let's adjust it a little bit using my very sharp knife and some pieces of sanding paper. And after this, I'm also going to cut the wolf's ears off. So now let's also prepare the body. First of all, I sand it with nail buffers to remove the glossy top from the surface. Then I clean it with an acetone-free nail polish remover. And then I cover both the face and the body with a couple of layers of some light acrylics using my airbrush, because I want to give this doll a skin color similar to the skin color of Billie Eilish. After this, I've also sprayed the doll's face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. Like this, I will be able to draw on this rubber surface. And while all these layers of paint and the sealant are drying, I have already here prepared the pencils and pastels, and you see that the colors are very normal, natural, very nude. We're not going to make anything very special on her face today. We're just going to copy the reference picture on the doll's face. Oh yeah, these pencils will be enough for it. And as a reference, I've decided to use this picture from the Bad Guy music video, because I really adore her hair color here, and I think also that her face expression here is very much Billie Eilish. So let's try to recreate it. And I begin, like always, with sketching her eyes and eyebrows. The eyebrows are going to be very trendy, of course, like dark, white, very wild. I draw the nostrils and work a little bit on the shape of her nose, and after this I'm going to move to her lips. And this is quite a challenging part, because I have to turn her smiling lips into a half open mouth without any smile at all. And after I've sketched all the main elements of her face, I can finally take soft pastels and blush it, creating a more realistic looking skin tone. And after this, it's time to add colors with my watercolor pencils. This layer I've repeated twice, and now I can draw shadows and highlights, and this step will make the face much more realistic and alive. This time I've decided to draw the lashes, both the bottom and the upper ones, because Billie has a very natural makeup and there is no special accent to her lashes at all, so I think false doll lashes would look quite alien here. And now I also want to draw the blood under her nose. I add reflections to her eyes using white acrylic paint, and with dark red acrylics I give some extra texture to this blood under her nose. So now let's also blush the doll's body, because it's supposed to match the face. And then with red pastels I add bruises under her knees, because you can find them both in the song and in the video. Okay, now let's make a wig for our Billie, and here I've got this acrylic yarn, and I think it has approximately the same color like her hair on the reference picture, so now we're going to turn this yarn into hair. And first of all I'm going to cut it into shorter pieces, and then I'm going to tie these pieces of yarn around some barbecue sticks. Then I split this yarn into single threads, and after this I'm going to brush it with this brush for cats. And yes, brushing yarn with a brush for cats is actually my full-time job. I don't know when it happened. Now I just need to make it straight with my mini flat iron, and the yarn starts to look immediately like hair. So now I can cut it off, put it onto some plastic surface, and apply tacky glue to this cut edge. A couple of hours later, when the glue gets completely dry, I trim these glued edges, and then I make a wig for her using my glue gun, like always. Now I'm going to cut her hair a little bit using this eyebrow razor, and it's just ideal for working with yarn hair. So the next step is making her outfit, and today I'm going to create a pair of short pants, a shirt with buttons on the front, a pair of socks, and also a pair of white slippers. And honestly, it's been really a while since I've made doll outfits myself, because nowadays, you know, my mom is mostly in charge for all this sewing and stuff. But anyway, today I'm going to show some class as well, I hope. But anyway, I've prepared here some white fabric already. I have also adjusted the patterns, so let's make it. Oh, and by the way, I'm using a special marker to draw on fabric. It disappears partially from itself, and the rest you can remove with some wet tissue or something like this. And please don't use regular markers or pens for drawing on fabric, otherwise it's gonna be really a disaster. You will not be able to get rid of it. So, and first of all, I'm going to make the short pants, I think. Attach the piece of Velcro to the back, and now let's make the creases. First of all, I draw a line where a crease should be with a marker, and then I iron it with a hair straightener. Okay, now let's make a shirt, and I begin with connecting all the parts together. I've attached a strip of Velcro to the front of the shirt, and on top of it I'm going to add a couple of super tiny buttons just as an imitation. These buttons are way too tiny to use them as real buttons. You see, even a very thin needle cannot go through. But they look amazing as a decoration, and the scale of them is just ideal for dolls. I just think I want to paint the buttons white, like we can see it on the reference picture, otherwise these dark buttons take too much attention. And now let's also make a pair of socks for her. I need to make a pair of slippers for this doll, and today I'm going to use a completely brand new material for this. It's called Warbla, and I've seen my beautiful fellow YouTuber doll artist Hexton using this kind of material for his dolls. And when I've seen how this thing works and what can you do make with this, I bought it just instantly, the same evening, really. So I really want to thank Hexton for this beautiful discovery, for the inspiration. And if you suddenly don't know his channel, if you don't know his art yet, I'm going to link it down below in the description box. I'm sure you're going to have lots of fun discovering his dolls. So, and now let's use this thing to make slippers for our Billie Eilish. The main feature of this material is that it becomes very soft if you warm it up with a hair dryer or with a heat gun. You can shape it then in any way, and then it gets very hard again, like it was in the beginning. And I think I've made very decent looking slippers just in a couple of minutes of working. Now let's cover them with a couple of layers of white acrylics, then I will put it all together, and then I will finally take a look at the end result pictures. So, and here is my mini Billy. I think she has become perfectly recognizable after all this job we've done today. And first I wanted to say that I loved her eyes especially. But actually I also like very much how her mouth turned out, and her hair looks really very good, and the short pants in combination with these bruises under her knees look also very real, as well as the slippers and the socks do. I just really hope, guys, that you love her as much as I do. And please let me know what are your thoughts and impressions here in the comments down below, because I'm really looking forward to hear your opinions today. And I know it's probably a little bit a crazy thing to hope for. I know Billie Eilish has a busy schedule. I've checked her dates for this summer, and yes, it's extremely busy, guys. But let's try to share this video and tag Billie on it. Who knows, maybe her or someone from her team would see it. Then I would probably simply explode. And can you also tell me who should become the next famous person for me to repaint? I know you want to see the guys from BTS, but let's wait a little bit till Mattel releases their official dolls, and then I will try to fix them. So, subscribe to not miss this transformation in the future, but who else should we make? And this doll will be available for sale on eBay for 3 days, so if you were interested in getting one of my dolls, you will be able to find the link in the description box. So, and that was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. If so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Subscribe to my channel, of course, and I will see you already very soon, next week Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.